Hello everyone, Zuzu Gaming here, and welcome to War Thunder. New update, Direct Hit is out. You can download it now. We have a bunch of new vehicles. I already checked most of them at the dev server. If you didn't watch it, click at the right top corner. And today I'm gonna be using T1 against players. Gonna use it in a ground realistic battle. It's a Soviet 5.7 strike aircraft. I'm gonna be comparing this directly to the Tu-2S. You might not be seeing Tu-2S being used in a ground realistic battle. And the reason is it's absolutely helpless against fighters. But if you didn't know, in squadron battles, you can pick planes with full loadouts at the beginning of the match, and bombers are spawning in midair while fighters spawn at the ground. And that's why lots of clan members at this BR using Tu-2S in the squadron matches. I'm pretty sure Tu-1 will not replace the Tu-2S because it's a strike aircraft. It's not gonna be able to spawn in midair in the squadron matches. Now let's go back to the ground realistic. In ground realistic, everything is set. I played some matches with this plane. It doesn't like to turn. You know, even though it says strike aircraft, it needs to have good nose lift, but it just won't do it. This plane also have a radar that tells you how many fighters are coming after you. Your turn rate is so bad, even German twin engines outturning you without any problem. T1 doesn't have bomber scope. It lifts its nose really slow. If you don't be careful, you're gonna crash basically. Don't get tricked by this illusion. You see big deca-decas there, right? Well, because of our maneuverability, it's only good in head-ons against other planes. But killing tanks with it, it's quite hard because of bad maneuverability. It has triple 1000 bomb that sometimes cannot kill enemies. These bombs only have 400 kilograms of explosive mass. Isn't it low? Let me check the Stuka. Yeah, this guy has 600. Gaijin, what the hell? So another illusion from the Soviets. Let's go back to Tu-2S. How much this guy have? 485. Okay. So Tu-1's one-ton bomb is actually weaker than the Stukas and the Tu-2S one-ton bomb. So that's why I'm getting bamboozled while I'm bombing the enemies, because they're sometimes not dying. They're surviving this bomb 50% of the time. It's basically a bit worse Tu-2S. Just because it's premium, I don't think it's even worth it. The only thing this plane is good about, probably destroying bunkers, pillboxes, AI planes, AI tanks in an air realistic match. So maybe by using this plane, you can farm much more you do than the IL-2. If you're gonna ask, hey Suslik, what should we pick instead of Tu-1? I will probably recommend you to get Tu-2S, obviously, the 44 version. It's not that different than the 59. Same, it can drop bombs 3 times. It has one-ton bomb and also double 500. It is maneuverable. It also have bomber scope. Good nose lift. But if you want to have chance against fighters and also pound the ground, I can recommend you to get good old Yak-9T, of course. And if you grinded for event vehicles such as ITP or Tisma back in the day, pick this ones. Like, these guys are just monster casses even at this BR 5.7. So guys, I'm not recommending this plane. It's not good. Just throw it to the trash can. Bad plane. Below average and worst than the Tu-2S. But yeah guys, that was it. I'll see you next time, and peace out.